yeah, 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 yeah. Say.
A few things I'm going to use for this hairstyle, and I'm also going to list them in the info section below. First thing I did was to color the hair bundles. You can choose to do the coloring however way you like, but this is what was more convenient for me at that moment. I colored the natural black virgin hair bundle from RPG Show with the 40 volume and the L'Oreal ash blonde color, and I simply followed the direction on the color kit in order to apply it to the hair and all that good stuff. You'll notice that I'm not taking the color all the way to the tip of the hair because I'm gonna end up cutting that part of the hair anyways. I'm sure you guys might be wondering, why don't I just buy some regular human hair from the beauty supply store that has possibly been pre-colored? But I love the feel and flow of this RPG Show hair, which is the same origin of hair that was used in my previous video, this one right here. So that's why I wanted to use it, and you know, I just wanted something a bit more custom, more personal, like I did it myself. And here's the result of that color process. And because I wanted some color variation in the wig, I deposited a cup of color on top of some pre-lightened dark blonde hair from Maven. And if you use like a kind of like a brownish, like a light brown color as well, that works too, like as long as the hair is sort of pre-lightened, because this particular color doesn't necessarily take to dark natural black hair too well. You have to kind of lighten the hair to a certain extent. I colored just about half of each bundle because I figured I'm not gonna need that much hair anyway to close up the top part of the wig. So just look at it as I used one whole bundle and a 27 piece hair to achieve this wig. I used the glue gun to construct the wig, and I started off with the shortest piece of the 27 piece hair in the back. And it's easiest to use glue to construct this type of wig because trying to sew on those little short pieces in the back can be a pain in the butt. And a glue gun lasts longer than regular hair glue. Once I got to a point where I felt like it was time for me to start closing up the wig, which is usually a point between the temples and the midpoint of your head or cap, then I started to use the hair bundles I colored. I glued those pieces in a circular motion so the circle started to get smaller. And I also alternated between both colored hair pieces in order to distribute them evenly.
Drumsticks.
London, Ola Paris,
Once I got to a final good closing point, I sewed on my lace closure piece, which I acquired from the tutorial that I did previously. And you guys may have no clue what I'm talking about at this point, or you may be a little bit lost. So I'm gonna leave a link to that video in the info section below, or you may also click on the screen if you're on a computer or something like that, and it's gonna redirect you to the video, and it's gonna sort of explain a little bit better. And I also colored that closure piece to match the rest of the hair. I'm I initially thought of doing a bowl cut, but I ended up going for something between a pixie and a bowl cut. So I cut the top bit all around first to the level where my ears would typically sit if I were wearing the wig. Then I went in to clean things up. Because I don't want the cut to be blunt, I cut some layers into it, and I also cut vertically into the ends to prevent too much of that blunt cut look, and just for things to flow a little bit better. I'm using a razor comb to clean up the back and make sure everything kind of mesh in together. And I took a clipper to further shape up the back. Once I got the wig to look somewhat decent, I finished it up by straightening and slightly bumping the hair at the top. Applying this wig doesn't require much, so you can just pop it on and go. Or you may also sew some wig combs on the inside for more security. I didn't want it to look all perfect and stuff, so I messed with it a little bit to randomly place the hairs at the top. And that is all.
He just came to steal the show. We just, I say 1, 2, 3. We just came to steal the show. Pass me the mic, then we rockin' and we go. I say 1, 2, 3. We just came to steal the show. Pass me the mic, and then we rockin'.